Examination of the jugular venous pressure. The central venous pressure, or CVP, is the pressure within the thoracic vena cava just before the right atrium. The superior vena cava and the connecting jugular veins act as a column of blood in which the CVP can be approximated by determining the jugular venous pressure. This is done by measuring the elevation of the neck veins above the sternal angle and correlating it to the height of the blood column in centimeters of water. The right-sided internal jugular vein is best for conducting this procedure since it is directly connected to the right atrium. The exam can also be performed on the external jugular veins, but they often branch at right angles, which can interfere with the test results. However, in this video, the external veins are used to perform the examination, since their superficial course and good visibility allow for the best demonstration of the technique. In the beginning, the patient should be recumbent with the head turned slightly to the left. The jugular veins are now at the same level as the right atrium and should be significantly distended under physiological conditions. The jugular vein presents with a regular pulse featuring a twin peak. The internal jugular vein's pulsations are not readily observable since it lies deeper within the neck. Its pulsation, though weak, can be observed just ventromedial to the external jugular vein. The CVP, or the height of the blood column above the right atrium, can now be estimated by slowly raising the patient's upper body by about 30 to 45 degrees. As soon as the distension of the jugular vein starts to decrease, halt the movement of the patient's upper body and locate the most cranial point at which the jugular vein is still distended. The vein now functions as a manometer that represents the CVP. Draw an imagined horizontal line towards the sternum, starting at the most cranial point at which the vein is still distended. Since the sternal angle lies about 5 centimeters above the level of the right atrium, add those 5 centimeters to the measured distance. This sum roughly represents the patient's CVP, measured in centimeters of water. This patient has a CVP of about 7 centimeters of water, which is within the reference range of 4 to 10 centimeters of water. If the sum is greater than 10 centimeters, the CVP is considered too high, as seen in heart failure, hypervolemia, or pulmonary embolism.